problem in the mean-value theorem portion, roles and other?
Sir, I am solving if I will have.
Okay. Always write me in the note in the WhatsApp group you send me. Okay.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Okay. I am telling it to all of you. Solve problem. Without solving problem, mathematics cannot be learned. Well, then let us start it. Everybody can see the screen?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Please don't, anybody don't start presenting, okay? And then everything will be spoiled. So today we will discuss the theory of maximum minima. I know that most of you are well conversant about the process, the working rule of maximum minima, because it is in your 12th level syllabus, calculus syllabus. So you know. Now here we will just do the same thing, but with a bit more detail, and some new aspects will be discussed, some new problems. So at the graduate level. We just wait 1 or 2 minutes, let everyone enter, then I will start. দেবেন্দ্র ছিল এতক্ষণ, কোথায় চলে গেল? So we start with the necessary condition for maximum and minimum. And we will discuss why it is necessary, okay? Why it is necessary, not sufficient. So if fx be a maximum or minimum at x is equal to c, suppose at the point x is equal to c, this function fx is attaining its maximum or minimum value. These are in general called extremum value. Okay, so fx is attaining its extremum value only when f dash c will exist, then f dash c must be equal to 0. So if fx is attaining its maximum or minimum at some point x is equal to c, and if at that point the derivative of f is existing finitely, okay, existing means existing finitely, then we must have f dash c equal to 0. Okay, let us first prove this thing, then I will show you, I will tell you why it is necessary condition. So okay, let us draw some figure, then it will be very clear to understand. Suppose this is our x and y axis. This is our x and y axis, and we have a curve.
Sir, someone waiting, please add him.
So the opposite is a curve. Now, at this point, we are having one. Just by inspection, we can say at this point, there is a maximum. Now, so suppose this is the point, suppose this is the origin, this is the point x is equal to c. As it has been given, at x is equal to c, the curve is having some maximum or minimum. Okay, then if you have another point at this point, say, or at this point. So let me denote this things at, say, C plus H, C C minus H, C and C plus H. So these are the points. কি গো হ্যাঁ হ্যাঁ আমার তো 19টা ক্লাস কি করব আমি এখন এই বুঝে বসলাম 4টে ক্লাস না আমি আমি তো আসছি তোমাদের তো ল্যাবে আমি আসছে আসতেই হচ্ছে আমাকে আমার কোনো কিছু নেই আমি এখানে করছি কিছু করার নেই আর আমার আমার সঙ্গে সবারই রিলেশন ভালো ভালো আমাকে ক্লাস করতে দিচ্ছি সবাই ল্যাবে ঢুকে অনেক কথা অ্যালাউ করতো না কেন দেবে যাই হোক সেটা আলাদা কথা কিন্তু এই হচ্ছে ব্যাপার আমার কোনো উপায় নেই অসম্ভব ব্যাপার পার্থ ছেড়ে গেল কাউকে নিল না তারপরে একে ছেড়ে গেল তোমার অভিজিৎ চলে গেল কাউকে নিল না আমরা পড়ে আছি অসম্ভব পড়ে আছি রুটিন দেখলে তুমি বুঝতে পারবে কি অবস্থা এরপর সোমঙ্গলবার ম্যাক্সিমাম ক্লাস রেখেছি বাড়িতে কোথাও শুক্রবারটা আছে এখানে
Sir, please talk in English.
No, I'm not talking. I'm not giving any lecture. I'm talking to my colleague. So now, this is your C point, okay? At this point, the curve is having maximum value. So suppose I'm talking about maximum first. Now, at C plus H, the Y coordinate will be minimum, less than this, FC, and this will be FC plus H. So FC plus H will be just, you can see, it is less than C. And also, FC minus H will also less than FC. Okay, so whatever, if you take H in the right hand side or left hand side, that means if H is a decreasing value on X axis or increasing value, that means H is negative in that sense with respect to C, H is decreasing. So in whatever manner you take, always the ordinate will be less than FC. So is it clear to all? Now, so I'm coming to this part. So FC plus H minus FC, this quantity, you tell me if FC is the maximum, so FC plus H minus FC, this part will be always less than zero. Okay, when I'm taking H in a very close neighborhood of zero, I have taken H in a very close neighborhood of zero. So suppose this is I've set zero origin here for H, okay? So now if I go here on the left hand side, H will be negative. Here if I go, H will be positive, okay? So actually, if this C minus H means some negative, some less than C and greater than C, C will be C plus H. Now, this FC plus H minus FC will be always less than zero. Okay. So if I divide this thing with H, so that will be also less than zero because H is greater than zero. H is greater than zero in our case. I've taken this point. I'm considering now this point. So H is greater than zero. Or C plus H is greater than C, I'm telling C plus H is greater than C. So if C plus H minus FC will be less than H is greater than, so this ratio will be less than zero, okay? So if I calculate this limit of FC plus H minus FC by H tending to zero plus, so H is a very small quantity, slightly greater than zero, okay? Then this thing will be less than or equal to zero. Now what this thing is actually, can everybody say? Can anyone say what this limit actually denote? FC plus H minus FC by H tending to zero plus.
This is the equation of continuity.
No, no, no.
Continuity.
No, the equation of continuity. No, equation of the expression of derivative at x is equal to c. It is nothing but the expression of derivative. What is the definition of derivative of fx? Fx plus h minus fx by h at x is equal to a. So f a plus h minus f a by h. Okay. So here I am just getting. I'm just getting df dx. So fc plus h minus fc by h, h tending to 0 plus. But this is only the right hand side derivative because I'm considering this change in x on the right hand side of c. So h is this change, small h is slightly greater than 0. So this is the thing, this is the right hand side derivative. Similarly, if I take h is negative, if I take h is negative, h tending to 0 minus, that means this point actually, this point. C, I can denote it by C minus H, or I can say C plus H when H is negative. Same thing, okay. I hope you are getting it. I can denote it with C minus H. I can also do it in by writing C minus H, no problem. Or C plus H, H is negative. H is very small negative quantity. So also this will be also less than FC. So in that case also this is less than zero, but in this case, H will be less than zero. H is less than 0 will mean the entire ratio will be greater than or equal to 0. That means the left hand side derivative of the dy dx will be greater than or equal to 0. Now, I'm claiming that the function is continuous. In the beginning, I told you a function must be continuous, okay? So it is not given here, but it is the foremost condition that function must be continuous. Otherwise, no analysis is possible. So if function is continuous, so the derivative cannot have, if derivative exists at that point, so it cannot have two different value. So the left hand side derivative and right hand side derivative must be same. So that means, what is the only possibility? When they can be same, tell me. When the left hand side and right hand side derivative will be equal to zero. Anyone tell me? When both the values are equal to zero, then only this and this can be equal and the derivative will exist. So when the derivative will exist at C, when C is maximum, then only one thing can happen. F dash C is equal to zero. Is it clear to all of you? Anyone is having any confusion? I'm again telling, if FC has a maximum value, then the derivative at the point X is equal to C will exist only when derivative exist means it should have the unique value. It cannot have two different value at that point. For example, if a point is continuous at a point, so the function must have a single value, na? It cannot have two different value at the same point. So this will contradict the condition of existence. So this derivative, dy dx, left derivative and right derivative for small change in h in the positive direction or negative direction, whatever it is, this should have the same value. And the same value can be only equal to zero. That is the only option. Because this can be less than or equal to zero. When it can be equal to zero, when C plus H is almost equal to C. When C plus H is almost equal to C, it will be less than equal to zero, or otherwise it is less than zero. Similarly, it will be greater than or equal to zero. When C plus H is almost equal to C, it will be equal to zero. That means when these two things is existing, the derivative of value of the derivative at the point C will be equal to zero. This equal to zero is the only option. So F dash C equal to zero. That is the thing why we're differentiating and equating to zero. Okay. I hope everybody is clear up to this. Now we are coming to this point. Why it is necessary condition? Necessary condition means if fx be, listen carefully, if fx is having a maximum or minimum, that is the extremum point at x is equal to c, then f dash c we must have f dash c equal to zero. There is no exception. If C is a maximum or minimum point, maybe local maximum minima, then f dash c must be equal to zero. But the converse is not true. That means if f dash c equal to zero, it does not necessarily mean that fx will have a maximum or minimum at that point. Okay. Again, I'm telling, when fx is having a maximum minimum, then f dash c must be equal to zero. But if f dash c is equal to zero at that point, it does not necessarily mean fx will have a maximum minimum. It may not have, may have. Okay. Again, let me draw a figure, then it will be very clear to you. Suppose, again, Okay, then again I'm drawing one thing this way. Now, if I take a point just here, okay, just this point, look at follow my cursor at this point. Okay, now do you think at this point the tangent will be parallel to x-axis? The tangent will be parallel to x-axis, so f dash c will be equal to zero. But do you think this point is having any maximum or minimum for this curve? This is the curve, okay? This is the curve. So what this point will be? Anybody knows?
Minimum point.
No, not minimum. This is minimum. The curve is going downwards. So there can be other minimum. This is another maximum. This point is having no minimum or maximum. Here there is a maximum or minimum. In that case, FC and other things we can compare. They will be less than or greater than whatever it is. Here, what you can say? If you draw some points in the neighborhood, will it be greater than this? No. So such point is called point of inflection. Okay. This is called point of inflection. Point of inflection. Okay. So at the point of inflection, somebody is waiting. At the point of inflection, you will have tangent parallel to x-axis, so f dash c equal to zero. But this point neither denote any maximum nor any minimum. Okay. That is why this condition will always not give you the maximum minimum values. Actual, this point may give you some point of inflection where the f dash c will be zero, but there is no maximum minimum. That is why the condition is sufficient. That is why the condition is necessary only. Okay. So in order to become a maximum minimum, there should be f dash c equal to zero, but the converse is not true. I hope everybody is clear to this. Anmol, you are clear?
Yes, sir.
Anyone is Joita?
Yes, sir.
Okay. And anyone else needs any explanation? Further explanation?
No, sir.
Okay. I think this is not very difficult. Anybody can understand this thing. So Dilshad, can you hear me, Dilshad?
No, sir. No problem.
Okay. So switching over to the next problem. So this I have already discussing. All these things you know now. So this is the working rule. Whatever I discussed is given in a short form. So if f dash c equal to zero and f double dash c is not equal to zero, this is important. If c is a point of the interval where f dash c equal to zero and f double dash c is not equal to zero, then there will be one maximum at x is equal to c for the function if f double dash c is negative. If f double dash c is negative, and if there will be one minimum at x is equal to c if f double dash c is positive. Okay. So this is the working rule, and this working rule can be a bit generalized. Okay. The generalized working rule, I don't know whether you know these things. So criterion B will be, okay, this is what I already said you, criterion B. If C be an interior point of the interval of definition of the function fx, and if it happens that not only f dash c equal to zero, but up to n minus one is derivative, that is f dash c, f double dash c, up to f n minus one c is equal to zero. If you put c there, it will be zero, okay? And f n c, the nth derivative, is not equal to zero. Okay, in ordinary case, n equal to 2. So f dash c equal to 0 and f double dash c is not equal to 0. This case we handle normally. But if it can happen that f dash c, f double dash c up to f n minus c 0 and f n c not equal to 0. In that case, the rule is that listen carefully. If n be even, then fc will be a maximum or minimum according as fnc is negative or positive, same condition. And if n be odd, then fc is neither a minimum nor a maximum. Okay, so I don't have any scope to give you the detailed proof of this thing, the general result. So this is not in your syllabus. So you just remember this thing and know how to solve problems. Okay, so I think this rule is clear to you. Again, I'm telling, if n be even, then there'll be one maximum minimum. And if n is odd, there'll be no maximum minimum. Okay, this is the general rule. Now, next we're coming to another issue that is called global maxima and global minima. So whatever will be this, suppose in this case, follow this figure, here there is a maxima, there is a minima, and it doesn't ensure that in some other area of the curve there is no another maxima which is even more than this maximum, or there is no other minimum which is even less than this minimum. There is no guarantee, because we are only inspecting the maximum minima in the neighborhood of a point. Okay, local, these are called all local maximum minima. Now, if the curve is given, if the curve is defined within AB, okay, so I am not interested what is happening outside AB. Suppose in the closed interval AB, we have defined a curve. That means, defined means curve is continuous and having derivative in the throughout the interval. Now, it is said to have an absolute maximum or global maximum at a point C if fx less than equal to c for all x in the closed interval AB. That means if fx is said to have an absolute, and also fx is said to have an absolute minimum if fx is greater than or equal to fc for all x belonging to closed interval AB. Okay, now how will you check this thing? Okay, I am telling for all value, all x in the interval, how can you check this thing? This is the rule for checking. Suppose after putting f dash c equal to 0, you are getting these roots, lambda 1, lambda 2, up to lambda n. There are n number of roots at which f dash x equal to 0. Okay, now to check the global maxima, you have to test for all these values, okay, and take the maximum of this. What is those values? What are those values? The values are fa, fb. That means the values at the terminal points, fa, fb, and f lambda 1, f lambda 2, up to f lambda n. That means those values, that means those local maxima minima. Again, I'm telling, this is restricted to an interval ab. So I'm interested to find the global maxima minima within the interval ab. So in that case, you not only check only f lambda 1, f lambda 2, and f lambda n. You have to check the total list from this, adding with fa and fb. Max of this should be taken, okay? And the absolute or global minimum of the fa should be taken also from the list fa, f lambda 1, f lambda 2, fb, okay? Now in that case, please check that. Please note that we are not checking the f double derivative. We don't need it, okay? Just to put all the values, all the evaluate all the values, function at points lambda 1, lambda 2, lambda n, and a and b. Whatever will be the maximum will be the global maximum. Whatever the minimum, the local minimum. Okay, so you don't have to check for f double dash c. What you have to do for local maximum minimum. Okay, this will be clear if I solve this problem. Okay, find the global minimum if the fx is x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 1 in the interval 0 to 2. Okay, this is 0 to 2, remember, 0 to 2. Okay, now fx is given to be x cube. Fx is given to be x cube minus 6x square plus 9x plus 1. Okay, so f dash x will be 3x square minus 12x plus 9. Now if I put it to 0, so that will give you two values of x, 1 and 3. These are lambda 1, lambda 2. Okay, these are lambda 1, lambda 2. Now, 3 we will not consider. 3 will not consider because we are restricted to the domain 0 to 2. So we have to find the global minimum or maximum, whatever it is, within 0 to 2. So we are excluding 3, so we are left with only 1. Okay, now we will check F0, F1 and F2. Are you getting F0, F1, F2? What is the value of F0? That will be 0, 0, 0, that is 1. 1. What is the value of F1? So 1 minus 6, so minus 5 plus 9. So plus 4, 1, 5. So F1 is 5. What is 2? That will be 2 cube is 8 minus 2 to the 4, 24. And 2, 19. So 19 plus 8, 18 plus 8 is 26. 26 minus 24. So 2 plus 1, 3. So this is the 3. So maximum of these things are obviously 5. So F1, the local maxima is in this case, the local maxima is the global maxima. Okay, the local maxima is the global maxima. Are you getting? So we don't need to check whether F double dash 1 is positive, negative, anything. Okay. But if you are not given this F0, F2 values, if you are just taking the F1, F2, the F lambda 1, F lambda 2, then which one is maximum, which one is minimum, we don't know. So we have to again check for F double dash X values, okay, at lambda 1, lambda 2. Similarly, global minimum can be found in this way, minimum of this. Again, same list, F0, F1, F2. That will be 1, that is F0. So see, the global minimum is not any point within this F dash C, not coming from this F dash X equal to 0 equation. It's not coming from that. It is only F0. So if you put 0, that is a left boundary, that if you put, that will be giving you the global minimum, 1. And global maximum is at X is equal to 1. Okay. So these are the, this is the process of finding the global maxima and global minima for any function. Okay. Everyone is clear? Please response.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
The next problem is again more interesting. Okay. I will tell you why this global maxima minima is important to consider. Suppose this gives given fx equal to tan inverse x minus half of log x. Tan inverse x minus half of log x. This is your function. Okay. We have to find the global maximum minima within this interval 1 by root 3 to root 3. Okay. Now, so f dash x will be 1 by 1 plus x square minus half of 1 by x. So if you add this thing, that will give you x minus 1 whole square by 2x into 1 plus x whole square. Now this will be 0 only when x equal to 1. So x equal to 1 is a value where f dash x equal to 0. But now if you go for the global maximum, you will find fa, fb and f lambda 1. Okay, again fa, fb and f lambda 1. So what is f 1 by root 3? F 1 by root 3 is tan inverse 1 by root 3, that is pi by 6 plus half of log 1 by root 3. Okay, 1 by root 3 is actually 3 to the power minus half. Minus half will be coming here because power within log can be taken in the left hand side of the log multiplier. So it will be plus 4 and pi plus log 3 by 4. Okay, plus log 3 by 4. So pi by 6 plus log 3 by 4. This will be the value at 1 by root 3. At 1, log 1 is 0. Everybody knows. So tan inverse 1 is pi by 4. So only pi by 4. And at root 3, that will be again pi by 3. Root 3, tan inverse root 3 is pi by 3 minus root 3. So half again will be there minus 1 by 4 log 3. So pi by 3 minus 1 by 4 log 3. These are the values. Now, it is evident that the maximum is this. Pi by 6 plus 1 by 4 log 3. This is the maximum. Okay. And the minimum is this. Pi by 4 minus 1 by 4 log 3. This is the minimum. You can check with your calculator. So the F lambda 1, the local maxima or minima, whatever it is, I don't know, but this is neither the global maxima nor the global minima. Okay. The global maxima minima are only existing at the terminal points. At 1 by root 3, at root 3. This will be the maxima, 1 by root 3, and this will be the minima, only root 3. This is interesting. So if you don't know how to find global maximum minima, what you will do, you will do it f dash is equal to 0, find x equal to 1, again double derivative it and do it. Okay, so that may be totally wrong. Is it clear to all? So this topic actually was in that way was in your 11-12 material, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Okay. This part was not done. So this way you have to find it. So this is a absolute minimum or global minimum. So this is the thing. Note, the absolute max or absolute min does not correspond to x equal to 1, where f dash x equal to 0. Okay. This is interesting. Let us take another problem. Find the maximum minima of this expression 1 plus 2 sin x plus 3 cos square x within the interval 0 to pi by 2. 0 to pi by 2. Okay. So fx is this. F dash x will be obviously 2 cos x and minus 6 sin x into cos x. 6 sin x into cos x. So taking 2 cos x common, you can take 1 minus 3 sin x. So this is your f dash x. So f dash x equal to 0. That will give you two values of x. When x is cos x is 0, that is x equal to pi by 2, this one. Okay, x is equal to pi by 2 is one value. Another value is 1 minus 3 sin x equal to 0, that is sin x is 1 by 3. In that case, we cannot find x because 1 by 3 is not in a standard angle. So naturally, we don't remember the angle x for 1 by 3. Let it be denoted by x is equal to sin inverse 1 by 3. That is the angle. Okay, sin inverse 1/3. So at these two points, x is equal to pi by 2 and x is equal to sin inverse 1/3, we have the extremum condition, local extrema. Okay. Now, then again, you do f double dash x. So your double dash x is equal to at x is equal to pi by 2 is 4. Okay, what is f double dash x? Tell me. Minus 2 sin x. Minus 2 sin x and plus 6 cos square x minus sin square x. Minus 6 cos square x minus sin square x. So if you put pi by 2, this sin pi by 2 will be minus 2. And this will be minus 6 into cos square x minus sin square x. Cos square x will be 0. Sin square x will be minus 1. So minus minus plus. So minus 2 plus 6. That will be 4. Okay, so positive, that means there is a minima, local minima at this point. X is equal to pi by 4, there is a local minima. And the minimum value, what is the local minimum value? If you put x is equal to pi by 2 there, it will be 1 plus 2 pi by 2, that is 1, so 3, and cos pi by 2 is 0, so this will be 3. So local minimum value is 3. Up to this is clear to all?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So now, yes, next we analyze these points, local maximum minima at sin x is equal to 1/3. So if double x is equal to minus 2 sin x minus 6 of 1 minus 2 sin square x. Here I am writing cos square x minus sin square x as 1 minus 2 sin square x. Why am I writing this thing? Can you say why I am writing this thing? Because if you keep cos x, so you will not be able to find cos x because don't you know for what angles cos x is sin x is 1/3. Okay, for which angle sin x is 1/3 you don't know. So corresponding causes you cannot directly calculate. So it is always intelligent to avoid this thing. So you write cos square x minus this one, cos square minus sin square x acts 1 minus 2 sin square x. In that case, you have to just put sin x is equal to 1/3. Okay, you don't know the value of x, so don't never need it. You do it, sin x, you put 1/3. So that will be 2/3 minus 6 into 1 minus 2 by 9. So total value is, what is that? Negative. Basically, it is negative. Okay, this is minus 2/3 and minus 9 by 2, 7 by 9 plus, it will be negative. So you can check. So these values at x is equal to sin inverse 1/3, if x is a local maxima. Okay, now within this interval, what is the global maximum minima? Can anybody say? It has not been calculated here. You calculate and tell me what is the global maximum minimum. Vishnu? Vishnu, can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
So what is the FA and FB values? Tell me, what are the values of FA and FB? What is the value of FA?
-1/2.
What is the value of A? What is the value of A? What is A here?
So 0.
0. So if you put 0, what value will come? FA?
4.
4. Huh, 4. Because sine 0 is 0, yes, 1 sir, plus 3, 4.
So yes, sir. And FB will be 3.
And FB will be 3. So 4 and 3. Now tell me 4 and 3. And what are the, these are the FA and FB values. And for cos x, the minimum value is 3. So, and maximum value is 4 1/3. That means the local maximum minima are the global maximum minima. Okay. Because this FA is 4, this is not greater than this 4 1/3, isn't it? The global is not greater than, so this local maxima is in this case within this interval, this should be treated as global maxima, 4 1/3. And also the local maximum minima is 3, and here is also we are getting 3. Okay, so global minima and local minima is same. That means FA and F pi by 2, these are same. F0 and F pi by 2. F0 is also F0 is 4. F0 is 4. And F pi by 2 is 3. So F pi by 2, FB. FB and local minima, these are same. FB and local minima, they are same. Okay. So, anyone is having any question on that?
No, sir.
No, sir.
Okay. So now this type of problem, you can find plenty of this type of problem is found. Okay, I will give you some assignment within week, within a week I will give you. But also you can, well, you should not wait for my assignment. In the net, there are plenty of such problems given, so you can practice from nets.
Sir.
Na bolo.
This is all similar like plus 2 continuity or any upgradation has happened.
Similar like class?
Plus 12. 2, sir, in 12 flavors, yeah.
This global maximum minimum within an interval, this part is, I think, new.
Yeah, this one
okay.
Is new.
This part is new and other part is same. I told you in the beginning, other part is same. But actually, the thing is that why this is a necessary condition that was not very clearly understood at that level. Isn't it true? Huh? So yeah, why sir. F dash x equal to F dash c will be 0? This part was, and when even F dash c is equal to 0, but there is no maximum minima, this part also understood, okay? So this detailing of the thing is there. Actually, the core part is same, but there are minimum. When you will solve some more problems, okay, let me solve another problem. Let me understand some problem, practical problem, okay? Applying the problem. Here, what I am doing, I am given a function, so you are finding the minimum maximum. This is simple. But there are some practical problems from which you have to construct this function, okay? Those problems are very interesting. Let us solve one such problem, okay?
Okay.
Let me find it first. Oh, I want to convert it. Yes. So everybody can see this screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay, this example 7. Find the point on the parabola 2y is equal to x square. This is the parabola, this is the origin. 2y is equal to x square, which is nearest to the point 0,3. So there is a point 0,3, this point. This is suppose A. Actually, A is given here, is A. So you have to find a point on the parabola anywhere where this length will be minimum. This length will be minimum. Okay. This is the thing. Now, if it was instead of a parabola, if it was a straight line, then what could be the value? It was just a perpendicular. Okay. So there was not much problem. It was just a perpendicular. We know from any point, the shortest length is perpendicular. But this is not a straight line. This is a curved line following a parabola. So this technique will not work here. So how to solve this problem? See. So what they're doing, they're finding a function for AP. So suppose PXY is any point on parabola and 0,3 is a fixed point. So AP square. AP square will be X minus 0 square plus Y minus 3 whole square. That means X square plus this Y. Now this Y can be replaced by X square by 2 because it will always satisfy as long as this point is on the parabola, it is X square by 2. So X square plus X square by 2 minus 3 whole square. So that will give you the function fx. Okay. That will give you the function fx. Now we have to minimize this function or maximize whatever is meaningful with respect to x. So that will give you some point on x. So f dash x equal to 2x plus 2 of x square by 2 minus 3 into 2x. Okay. And there will be one half. So this half and this 2 will cancel. So only 2x will remain. Okay. There is one half. So it will be ultimately x cube minus 4x. If you put it to 0, that will be 3x square minus 4, x cube minus 4 is equal to 0. What is that? What value should come? Tell me. F dash x equal to 0. So obviously one value is x equal to. What values you will get? X equal to 0, first of all. X equal to 0 and x equal to not only 2. X square
minus
4 equal to 0. That's you are not in class 9-10 now. You have to consider everything. Even you cannot cancel x both sides in an expression, suppose if you are multiplied x both sides, you're just canceling it. So do you know what you are doing actually? You are actually eliminating the possibility of a solution x equal to 0. We are assuming that x not equal to 0 by canceling it. Because I can cancel. That cancel means division. I can divide x with x. This is meaningful only when x is not equal to 0. So when x into something is equal to x into another thing, you cancel x both sides. This we always often do in the class 9-10 level. But there is an underlying assumption that x is not equal to 0. So if you cancel it, you are missing one solution. So these things, these points are to be keep in mind in the higher level. So x is equal to 0 and x is equal to plus minus 2. These are the points. Now let us check whether these points are maximum minimum. Now at x is equal to 0, what is the value of the function? What is the other function? Fx is maximum and f is 0. What is f double dash x? That is 3 into 4. Okay. 3 into 4 at x is equal to 0. Check it. What is f double dash x? 3x square minus 4. At x is equal to 0, it is minus 4. Okay. At x is equal to 2, this should be. That means at x equal to 0, there is a local maxima. Are you getting? At x equal to 0, there is a local maxima. You keep it in your mind. Okay. You keep it in your mind. Local maxima. Then again, x is equal to 2. So 2 to the 4 minus 3, 12 minus 4. That is positive. That is minima. Local minima. And x equal to minus 2. Again, minima. So maximum value is not required, only 2 and minus 2. Only plus 1 is 2. Here the function will have some minimum value. This AP. This AP is a function. AP square is this. What I was calculating, AP square. So AP square will be minimum when x equal to plus minus 2. Okay. And what are the values? If you put here 2 square, that is 4 by 2, 2 minus 3, minus 1 square, 1, 2 square, that is 5. Okay, are you getting? 2 square is 5 and 2 square by 2 is 2 minus 3 minus 1 square is 1. So 5. Similarly, for x equal to minus 3 is also 5. So AP is minimum at x is equal to plus minus 2 and the value is 5. The value is 5. So the points are x equal to plus minus 2, and if you put x equal to plus minus 2 there, y will be 2. Y will be always 2. Okay. So plus minus 2 y equal to 2. That means 2, 2 and minus 2, 2. 2, 2 and minus 2, 2. These are the required points. So there are 2 points. It is very evident from the figure. If there is a point 2, 2, so there should be one point by symmetry minus 2, 2. Okay. Suppose this is a point 2, 2. So that will be another point minus 2, 2. This will be also of the same length by symmetry. So there should be two points. 2, 2 and minus 2. Okay. So this type of problem are interesting when you are constructing a function and then solving it. Okay. Anybody is having any doubt, any question on that?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, next problem is a long problem. Today I'm not going to discuss this thing. Let it be discussed in the next day. So next day again we will continue some portion of maximum minimum, then I will conclude it. I will switch to integral calculus. So I will give you only another day for maximum minimum, and maybe some more problem on mean value theorem. Just if I find anything interesting, I will give you. Okay, so I will conclude this mean value theorem, this differential calculus portion in the next day. Okay. And I will advise you to solve as problem as more as you can. Okay. So okay, all of you give your attendance on your Google form, and I'm concluding for today. Okay,
thank you, sir.
Okay, bye.
Sir.
Thank you, 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 everyone.
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Do not give Shruti, do not give in the group, in the WhatsApp group. Do not give in the WhatsApp group. You have the Google form link given. See the form I have given you. Google form link, submit there. All of you submit there, okay?